female NBC correspondent sides with Franken instead of victim in photo. NBC correspondent sides with Franken instead of victim. Not long after a woman came forward and accused Democratic Senator Al Franken of Minnesota of assaulting her, one political pundit downplayed the severity of Franken's disturbing behavior. On Thursday, NBC News correspondent Xie Hunt, who also anchors her own show on MSNBC, was discussing allegations that Franken had sexually assaulted CAB's on-air personality Lynn Tweeden in 2006. Tweeden accused Franken of kissing and groping her without her consent while she was asleep. Tweeden also had photo evidence, which clearly shows Franken with his hands on her breasts while he smiles for the camera. Discussing the photo on Thursday, Hunt said Franken was not actually groping but mock-groping Tweeden's breasts. As noted by Breitbart, Hunt used that same inexcusable line of thinking a second time in the segment to downplay the severity of Franken's actions. She also published a picture that was given to her of her asleep with Senator Franken mock-groping her, Hunt said. On two separate occasions, Hunt said Franken only mocked-groped Tweeden, as if he was only joking and that such vile behavior should be tolerated. Franken is a Democrat, after all. While Hunt didn't make any mention of it, a second woman came forward Thursday and claimed Franken had harassed her years ago. On Thursday, radio talk show host Melanie Morgan came forward and detailed her own experience with Franken nearly 20 years ago before he became a member of Congress. Morgan said Franken stalked her and wouldn't leave her alone after they had a disagreement in August 2000 about then-President Bill Clinton's budget during a segment on ABC's Politically Incorrect with liberal comedian Bill Maher. Morgan said Franken harassed her after the show, demanded her phone number from the show's producers and harassed her via phone for several days. As noted by Newsweek, in Franken's first apology on Thursday regarding the groping allegation, he said he didn't recall the incident in the way that Tweeden did, but offered a weak apology. "I certainly don't remember the rehearsal for the skit in the same way, but I send my sincerest apologies to Lynn. As to the photo, it was clearly intended to be funny but wasn't. I shouldn't have done it," he said in a statement. Franken issued a second statement later in the day, where he again apologized to Tweeden and said he would be in favor of a bipartisan congressional ethics committee investigating the allegations. While it appears Franken is in hot water, it's also unacceptable that Hunt made two attempts to defend Franken's sickening actions. "We cannot allow partisan politics to take over decent human behavior,"